This is Tetris, the tabletop strategy game. It's an official Tetris product from Buffalo Games. You can tell by the two pieces of tape holding the box shut. Let's open it up. What's that say? Hey, it's Phil! Actually, I wasn't familiar with that name, but apparently Phil Walker Harding is a talented and popular board game designer. So, does this game build on that legacy? Well, the packaging is nice. These are the Tetris pieces. I like the sound that they make. Too bad they're not metal. But the game was less than $16 at Amazon. That's why I wasn't too mad when I saw minor imperfections on the Tetris towers. Also, these bags were included too. Perhaps if the game goes too long, I can use it to pack a small sandwich. I'm just kidding. That's for organizing the pieces when the game is over. Two sets of cards are included too. Did they hide anything underneath? Nope, that's the whole game. What's nice is how the cards have their own spaces when they're put back in the box. But we haven't even played the game yet, so let's get things set up. This piece is like a board, so does it count as a board game? Head-to-head strategy sounds more serious. It's at least a two-player game, so I'll need another player. Hey Yoshi, are you ready to play? The Tetris Tower is holding him up. Where are my manners? Yoshi needs a seat so he doesn't fall down. This empty glass container from a previous vanilla and chocolate yogurt snack is quite handy. The instructions say to put the pieces in reach of all players. Yoshi's arms are a bit short. Since he is merely a cute dinosaur, I'll be helping him out. The next step is to organize the Tetris pieces. There are a lot of these pieces. But the game is not completely random. Since the variety is based on the cards, a set amount of pieces are expected to show up. Except this piece. It's an orange L piece. L for loser card. Into the box you go. I'm not sure why the game wants to remove one card from the deck. But that's what the rule said. Although, I wasn't supposed to look at it. Perhaps it's a very minor deterrent against counting cards. I'll just flip that over. I'm playing against a plushie. Obviously, this isn't a serious match. So we can start playing now, right? Wrong. There's a second bag of pieces. While this seems like a chore, that's the essence of board games. You're supposed to sit around and chit-chat while the game is being set up. So hey Yoshi, do you know when the next Nintendo Switch is launching? Oh, non-disclosure agreement. You can't say? I understand. So how's Luigi doing these days? Another argument with Mario. I'm not surprised. Anyway, that's it for the Tetris pieces, but the cards need to be placed too. The instructions say to draw 6 achievement cards. The current and next cards are ready too. The last thing is to pick a Tetris color token. Why? I don't know. But since Yoshi is green, he gets a green token. And since I don't like the other colors, I picked green for me too. Hopefully picking the same color doesn't cause a problem. So I think that's it. The setup is complete. Who goes first? Heads, I go first. Tails, Yoshi goes first. What's this say? We're supposed to go at the same time. Well, that solves the order problem. Although, that seems like it would start fights. How are we supposed to play pieces at exactly the same time? Getting the pieces to line up can be tricky, but the straight blue piece went right down the side. Nice move, Yoshi. My move is similar, just on the opposite side. I was waiting for Yoshi to make his move first. Too bad that straight piece showed up so early. Now it's the backwards L. It's a dark blue piece. The pieces can be rotated 90 degrees, but they can't be flipped. Are you ready, Yoshi? Is this where you want to go? Oh, I think Yoshi ate too many Goombas. He looks full. Along the side looks nice. There you go, buddy. Let's get you back on your glass yogurt chair. Do you see how it doesn't let you flip the piece? And next to the straight edge looks nice. The purple tea piece is next. Yoshi makes a respectable move. While I'm getting a mulligan. What? It was hard to see the columns from this angle. Oh, once the pieces start falling into place, the pace of the game picks up. It's clearly not as fast as the video game, but this is a video, so we can speed things up. Things were going all right until I realized something was missing. Those single black squares are part of the game too. If I'm understanding the rules correctly, they're awarded when a played piece aligns with the Tetris Tower icon. It's kinda like a power-up. The single squares can be played before placing a regular piece. But be careful, those smaller pieces can get stuck. This is great for preventing empty squares. That's what's interesting about this game. I'm playing against myself, and the cards are the same, but somehow this giant bubble was created. Yoshi's tower doesn't have that problem, so there is strategy at play here. Just look at the comparison. With all the cards drawn, it's 2 points per row, and 1 point for matching a Tetris piece. I don't think the mini pieces count. That means the final score is 26 to 22. Although there are achievement cards, which are awarded after completing 6 rows. That part of the game was missed, but I don't think it would have changed the outcome here. There's not much else to do but congratulate the winner. And then put the pieces back into the box. I like how it can be packed up neatly once again. Anyway, that's pretty much the game. What do you think? Do you like this version of Tetris? You can let everyone know in the comments.